This is a problem many SwiftUI developers are struggling with. Why doesn't SwiftUI have a text field for money input? Well, finally we have an answer. Say hello to currency field, the missing SwiftUI text field for handling currencies. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and smash that like button, and let's see how to create a text field that handles currencies. Let me show you how powerful currency field is. And we are going to see this inside one of my simulators. It's an iOS simulator, but currency field works really, really well on macOS, iOS, tvOS, watchOS, of course, all of the Apple devices. So this is how it looks like. This is the demo project, actually, that you are going to get access to once you take a look at currency field. And this is what we add in here. Let's add in some cents right over here. And if I try to tap more, as you can see, it's not going to add more as expected. And if I delete here, as you can see, it's just deleting the dollar sign also. And of course, here are the tremendous ways that you can customize this. Let's just have some tip right over here, 0.80, and we can also delete that. So this is what we are going to build out today. Go ahead and check out currency field. It's at store.rebeloper.com/currency field. Now, what does currency field do? Well, it's a text field for handling currencies, and it's really, really awesome. It works on all of the devices or platforms that I have told you about. Its setup is a free, simple step setup. It has a currency field style modifier, if applicable for that platform, of course. And the really, really great thing is that it converts the text field string value into a double. So you can use that value in your code. Furthermore, maybe just send it to a server. Also, it adds and removes that currency symbol and from the to and add from the text field, and it has built-in currencies that you can select from. Otherwise, you just add in your string value. It automatically adds in the decimal number pad keyboard and limits the decimals to count of two. Built on SwiftUI 5.6, it has an example project and it's 100% documented. And if you want to take a look at the steps and some really nice screenshots with all of the platforms, go ahead and check out. It's at store.rebeloper.com/currency field. Now let's take a look at our example. So what I'm going to do is open up my Xcode. Here is my dummy project, well, demo project actually. And what I have done is just added an example view that I'm going to present right over here instead of the content view. The content view has all of the text fields, well, currency fields that are actually text fields inside it itself that you have already seen. And yeah, we have a simple hello world. Let's just build and run right over here so we can see that everything works as expected. There we go. And what we are going to do is add a currency field. Now, all you have to do is just add in the currency field library that you have downloaded it after your purchase, and then you can just set this up in a few easy steps. Now, first one is creating a private state object, and let's just name this currency. And there are a lot of ways that you can set up your currency. Let's just see one way of doing so. As you can see, we can add in a string value, a currency type. We can add also optionally a title and the title foreground color. So let's just go with a simple one with a type. Let's add a dot right over here, and you can see all of the default ones here. Let's just choose euro here, and that's it. We have our currency set up. Now we have to add in our currency field. So just type out currency field, open parentheses, and add in your currency. And believe it or not, that is all you have to do right over here. I optionally add also a currency field style of rounded border, because I think it looks really, really nice. By the way, you can just customize it to your needs. As you can see in the content view, we have a lot of customization options right over here for this currency field. We added a font, foreground color, padding, background. You know, it's all Swift UI. Okay, so let's see how this looks like. Let's build and run and see our currency. There we go. We have our euro sign right over here. If we tap over there, we have 25 point, maybe 54. And if I try to add, nothing is added furthermore, which is really, really great. And we can just delete that. It's really nice. By the way, I do like the one with euro with space, so it adds a space after the symbol. And let's just add, instead of hello world, let's grab our currency's value. So the currency value is actually a double. So what we need to do is add string interpolation right over here and grab the currency that we have created and add a dot, and you will see that we have a value right over here. So let's build and run again, and let's see if that value is added right over here. Yes, it is. So let's add a 12 right over here and the dot, maybe 78. And as you can see, it's automatically updating. It's really, really cool. Okay, so let's see what other options do we have. Of course, all of this works. And I will just add in back in my content view right over here. It also works on all OSs. So as you can see, I just added here some if and if delimiters, because for example the currency field of rounded border is not available on tvOS and watchOS. This is a SwiftUI thing, of course. And let's see, what we added here is a currency field style, which we already saw there. By the way, just check out how awesome these initializers are. You can have a Bitcoin with space, a Swift coin, just a simple string, USD. We can add a title of price and also a foreground color of white. Okay, so let's just add it right over here. Let's build and run and let's see how this looks like. For example, 1, 5, there we go. It's really, really great. As you can see, it is really, really customizable. Let's take a look at this price also. There we go. If we delete and Swift coin, maybe if we bought some Swift coin, that's really imaginary right over here. And some Bitcoin, there we go, 25, maybe 00, and that's it. You saw the dollar currency field right over here. Now, all of this is inside the demo project, and you can purchase this at store.rebeloper.com/currency-field. As you can see, setting up a currency field with currency field is really, really straightforward. And if you want to learn about the 6 senior developer habits, go ahead and check out the video right over here.